Good morning. It's bumping in here. Day, what is it? 31. That's a month now. We're going to do some overhead press. We're going to do 5A. I'm going to drop the weight down. I'm going to work on the eccentric today. So more control, because I've been hard stuck at the 135 for like 6 or 7 for 3 weeks. So we're going to mix up. I'm going to drop the weight, work on the eccentric, and do a 5A. We got 125 on right now and see how that feels. It feels pretty light. Maybe bump it up 5 more pounds or something. But anyway, thanks for being here. Let's get at it. All right, good morning. Day 31, happy month. We did it.
I guess I gotta keep my word and compare the progress from day one to now.
I'll work on that. I'll do that this weekend. That'll be a fun Sunday video. So we'll do the,
have I been recording the whole time? Oh, you just tapped on my face. I thought you hit the record. I'm like, I've been yapping and
But we'll do some progress updates this weekend. That'll be fun. But yeah, thank you so much for being here. We got overhead press, gonna do a 5A. I'm gonna work on the eccentric today because I've been kind of hard stuck at 135 for like 6 to 7. It's what I've been liking. What I'm enjoying doing is like a 5A on my compound. So we're gonna drop it. We got 125. Gonna really work on the slow, controlled, feeling the weight down and then pressing up. See if they can kind of get me over this little plateau I got going on. But anyway, let's get after this. We got chest, a lot of incline, a lot of flies. I think we're gonna start with flies like we did last week too, but let's go. Play a crazy song. That's heavier for sure. You have to help on this one.
Push.
That was slow. I like that. So 7. Let's take these fives off and let's just do 115. Really controlled. But that felt good. That was an awesome first set. So I said 25s and a 5, the 35s. So that's my bad. So now we got 115 on. I think 7's fine. But I definitely want to get 8 or more. And I don't think I would have got 7 at the same weight, just going off of feel. So I'm gonna drop the weight down just a little bit, but the eccentric, I gotta do better on my cadence. I feel like overall, a lot of my lifts have gotten better as far as control and slow instead of like the ego style. But my shoulder exercises have been pretty poor when it comes to the cadence and the timing. But I'm feeling a lot better today. Thanks for asking, by the way. Feeling way better. That rest day was much needed yesterday. All right, let's do 4 more. All right, go. Okay. Dang, it's always seven, man. That was sick, though. All right, let's do three more. I got three more, right, Cody? I did two sets, didn't I?
Yeah, you got two.
That's it? Dude, the slow eccentric, man. Oh, let's go. My ego's. That's okay. This is a lot. I mean, if you think about it, it's a lot of weight over your head. So, I gotta get over this plateau. So, let's do this. I am going wider today, too. Cadence was a little bit faster, but I still feel like that was really good in control. Woo! Two more sets. Oh my goodness. Cody is goofy. He's talking about like flexing my quads, because I was like, yo, my quads, I'm finally getting some definition. And I was like, my calves are looking better too. He's like, your calves are turning into cows. Jesus, we're such dads, such dads. Okay, two more of these. I'm sweating. It feels like spring outside. It's only like 35 degrees, but it feels nice out. I'm burning it up. Let's get, oh, hold on. There we go. My leg was shaking on that one. That was sick. All right, let's do one more set. I'm gonna need about a 5-minute breather. My shoulders rest. Last set, so just like last week, to get that chest activation early, we're gonna do some flies, some high to low flies. I think we did three sets. We might do, I don't know. We'll do three, maybe four today. Just, you know, just a slow squeeze. And then after that, we'll do some incline. Barbell, and then do some pec deck and some dips, and we're gonna do I want to do that chest iso press, maybe as like a finisher, keep it light and just the, you know, it's more of a squeeze. It's kind of like an incline too, but my upper pec needs a lot of work for sure. I mean, my whole entire chest does, but I want to really focus on the upper part for the next, you know, little while anyway. Let's do one more set. My music will play. Cody, I'm just gonna get the old cord back and keep it plugged in the whole time. All right.
Push, 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 push,
That's perfect. Woo! Let's go do some flies. Yeah. Cable flies, high to low. So remember, start like a push and squeeze at the bottom, shooting for at least 12. But I'm gonna always go into failure on these accessory lifts. So. Yeah, that was perfect. Was that 13? Let's do two more sets, see how we feel. Good. Okay, that's perfect. Hey, those are sweet, dude. I'm like that last rep, like the past time, like cramped up. I'm like, ugh. I feel like I got electrodes on my chest. It's just like, ugh, zapping. All right, that made no sense. All right, let's do one more. Last one. I was being a little ambitious and I was thinking do four, but those first two. I didn't know a better analogy, but I almost felt like I was still in like full contraction when I let go of the weight. This is sick. No point in overdoing it, right? I got a full pump already. I'm ready for some incline barbell. So I'm actually thinking about axing the pec deck. I say we do incline barbell. We do dips. We do the iso press. And then we do incline flies to end it off. See, Cody's like, we'll see. What's this? Because I don't know if I'm a big fan of pec deck. I mean, I like it, but you know what I'm saying? I don't know. It's a personal preference. But I want to do some more of that iso press for that squeeze. All right, let's do it. Enough yapping. Cody doing an action shot. Thanks, bro. This is gonna be sick. Cody, you know what's awesome about Cody? I didn't even ask him to do that. That was awesome. That was awesome. Thanks, buddy. Last week, we ended with 155 for eight. I'm going to focus more on the cadence today like I have been. Cody just, he had to leave early last week, so I didn't want to get crazy with the eccentric and get stuck, you know. Not that I couldn't ask someone else to spot me, but... We're going to start 135. I'm going to go to failure with it. I don't know how many I can get. And then after that, we'll put 155 back on and really focus on controlling it. I'm thinking like a 4-second cadence, like 2 seconds down and 2 seconds up, something like that, you know?
My music. Dude, these are AirPods, bro. There we go.
I'm gonna keep that same weight.
Okay.
That same cadence. I think that was 9 or 10. I think it was 9. Yeah. All right. Let's just keep that. That felt good. All right. Let's do this for 3 more sets. I don't know if you guys can see on the camera. I'm going wider today too. Felt so fast. So that cadence was faster, and I got, well, 9.5.
That seemed like a really good cadence, though. It didn't seem like you're going too fast on that.
Yeah. Thanks, bro. Nah, but Cody's getting strong, dude. Woo, that's what's up. That's what's up. That means the split's working, guys. Right, so don't talk smack about my split anymore. All right, let's do 2 more sets. Chest feels good. Oh. Yeah, I don't know if I like the wider grip. It feels good. But, you know, incline barbell is so new to me, too. I know we've gotten stronger. I know we did a 155 for 8 for 2 sets last week. Those are pretty ego-style sets. But the first week we did 135, it seemed like I only got it, like, 8 times, maybe less. So the fact that I'm getting it, you know, 10, that's reassurance. And these are pretty slow and controlled reps too, but it's just gonna take time. I think incline barbells especially hard after doing shoulder press too, because your front delts are pretty taxed after a lift like that. You know what I mean? I'm not trying to make excuses. You know what I'm saying? Right, let's do 2 more sets. The music will play. Dude. It's because I keep unplugging them and plugging them back in. Cody. I'm just gonna have to do it without music. It just made the doo-doo, like it disconnected. Yeah, I got no snare in my headphones, man. I gotta do better about flexing my quads.
Yeah.
My legs kinda got squirrely the first. I'm just not used to doing incline. But yeah, I was really pushing on my quads. Remember I talked about like an early chest video. When you got your feet planted, like get close to your body, you pretend you're standing on paper and like you're almost sliding it out. Don't raise your butt up, but push your toes out, if you will, and then just flex your quads. Helps a little bit. Dude, my abs are still sore from the and deadlift. All right, 1 more set. That was perfect. He's speaking another language. Talk about rebuilding cars. I'm just like, yeah, cool, man. I know how to change tire and oil and brake lines, you know. I can change brakes.
That's about it. I felt really strong that last one.
I like the wider grip. It was a little hard on my wrist, you know, last week.
Because I've been so used to going narrow. But I had a couple of power lifters talking to me to go a little bit wider. So I'm just, you know, I'm being open to it. But I felt really strong. I felt really stable in it. That was the best set.
And climb barbell yet.
Felt good.
I feel really strong with that grip. Let's go do some dips.
Yeah, it'd be sweet.
Alright, the assisted dip machine was taken up, so this is a dip bar. I don't know what you call this thing. I'm not gonna try to act like I know what it's called, but I know you do dips on it. So let's do as many body weight as we can, and then maybe that assisted machine will be available in a minute, and then we'll go hop over there. Actually perfect. Just do that 9 times, well, 8.5 I think. Maybe just stay here. I don't really know where to put the tripod, so give you guys a couple of close angles here. Just remember on chest dips like this, you want to lean forward a little bit and squeeze your bottom pec when you come up. Do 3 sets of these. I didn't rest that long that time. Let's take a 3-minute rest this time. Do one more set. That felt good though. All right, last set. I went down a rep every set. That's good though, we're going to failure. All right, let's go do some iso press. All right, let's do some iso press. I thought about doing the one arm, Bradley Martin, across the body where you lay on your side like this, but the machine, because I feel like when you do it on this machine, it's more lower pec, and we've already done high to low and dips. I wasn't feeling a really good connection with the middle of my chest or my upper chest doing this, because it's kind of pushing out and down a little bit. I don't know, for whatever reason, but when I'm like this, it feels really good, like right in the middle of my chest, right in the middle of my pec. I don't know, but the one I want to do, someone else is on it with a trainer, so let's just stick with this. Maybe next week we'll fill that in. That might be a good variation instead of incline dumbbell flies too. I'm not trying to get crazy, I'm just trying to figure out, I'm trying to make all my exercises S tier, you know what I'm saying? We're narrowing it down though. But we're gonna do 2 sets of these. Really a lot. Like 15 reps. Squeeze it inside. Yeah. Yeah. This feels so good, man. The way the machine starts out and comes in is so good. Let's do one more set like that. That's pretty perfect. Well, let's see how we feel. Play a song. Crazy song. Cody, did you check out the Spotify yet?
No, not yet.
What? What kind of, you like hard rock too? Huh?
I'm new to Spotify.
Yeah, you know, I would have switched to Apple Music, but I've had Spotify for like 12 years. I have like, my locked playlist has like 6,000 songs, and I don't, not that I would miss any of them, because I usually skip through them anyway. I'm the type of dude that I listen to a song like 16 times or 100 times, I'm just like, well, this song sucks now, you know? This Kool-Aid song is dope, man. It's dope. I put it on like every one of my shorts and TikToks. I don't know. A lot. Yo, I'm thinking about, you're gonna roll your eyes. I'm gonna do one more and just be done with chest. I feel so good. I don't think there's any point doing incline flies because I'm feeling it. So like when I keep my shoulders retracted, like the whole time, kind of doing this, I can really, like I have that connection. I don't know. I'm just gonna do one more and just be done.
I think that's a good idea.
Hungry? Nice one. Oh. I need some more tattoos, bro.
Huh?
I need some more tattoos.
Yeah, it's like, it's the measure of your mindset.
Yeah.
Gotta draw out the hand, and you gotta start the other.
Yeah, I'm thinking like a gorilla. That'd be tough right here, wouldn't it? Like a gorilla?
A fucking gorilla.
Yeah. I don't know.
It's like you gotta show your kid, like, gorilla pictures. Hey, wouldn't that be cool?
Yeah.
Yeah, pick that one. Yes!
Yeah. Yeah, so, long story. I know I talk about my kids, you know, briefly, but I've been bribing my oldest to ride his bike, and I was like, you can draw daddy's next tattoo, and he's like, all right. I'm like, so what are you going to draw? He's like, a bowl of spaghetti. Like, what? He's like, with skull meatballs. I'm like, oh my goodness. So I'm getting a bowl of spaghetti right here. Maybe I'll get a small one in here somewhere. That'd be fun. Oh, this handle's coming off. This handle is coming off. Alright, see you in the studio. Sick day. Your favorite part of the videos is here. Chest days as the shirt comes off. So, I'm putting a stamp on it right now. That is our chest day from now on. I don't know about the same sets, but the lifts and in that order felt so good. Felt so good. I have a wicked pump. Dude, the iso press, keeping my shoulders retracted the whole time, I made an insane connection with my upper pec in the squeeze. There was no point in doing incline flies, you know? So, but yeah, it was, I feel like it was great cadence all day. Energy was good. It was a good lift. It was a W. But yeah, let's take this shirt off. Wait, I wanna do one of these poses real quick. Try one of these new ones. All right, now you guys can see the belly. So I am gonna do a comparison this weekend. So this will be 1 month of chest compared to the, you know, first week. You know what I'm saying? Let's do the same one. Dude, I want to cut. I'm not ready, though. I'm not ready, Cody. All right, I'll see you guys in the truck. No, dude, I got abs.
It ain't about abs. It's about we fat. You look like you're having a seizure.
I know. I'm shaking. See you in the truck. Day 31 is done. It's been a month. That's crazy. I know I talked about this the other day. It is just bizarre to me. Because it feels like this whole thing has went by so fast, but I swear, like, my first video, when I think about it and, like, editing it and stuff, it feels like several months ago. I don't know. It's crazy. But a month down and, you know, a million more to go. Oh, man. I don't really have an end goal in mind. I mean, I do want to compete. And I realize I have a lot to learn, and my body has a long way to go before I do that. But I'm committed, man. Like, I took a freaking scale to the restaurant. Like, I want this so bad, and I'm having so much fun. But I guess just intermediate goal. I just want to get bigger. I just want to keep growing, man. Like, I want abs and stuff for the aesthetic and for you guys when I do the posing, but I just want to be big. I want to crack concrete when I walk, and I want to do it naturally too, you know, for a while. We'll be natural for a while. Maybe dabble in some stuff in the future, you know, when I reach my genetic potential. But enough yapping. So the overall volume for overhead press went down today for sure because we lowered the weight, but the form improved a lot. So I'm not mad about it. I'm pretty happy with it. And today was, like, the third set on incline barbell. That third set clicked. I don't know what it was. I just felt so strong on that third set. You know, like, the first two sets, I think I got, like, 8 or 9. But then the last two, I wasn't even taking that long of a break. But the last two I got for 10. And I feel like my base was strong. I just felt strong. So I think it finally clicked. I don't know if it's my elbow positioning or what, but the wider grip, it just felt good. That lift is going to improve a lot pretty quick. I could tell by how strong I felt today. But here's my progressions for overhead press. And then here's my progressions for chest day. So we didn't do the iso press last time. I still might do the one-handed. I don't know. You know what? Let's just keep. This is our split. This is our chest. This is our shoulder and chest day for the next 3 weeks, and then we'll do the deload week, and then we'll reassess our one rep max. But yeah, I'm happy with the chest day. There was no point in doing incline flies, man. When I kept my shoulders back the whole time and really focusing, squeezing my upper pec, I just made a crazy connection. And after I finished that second set, I'm like, why? I'm just gonna do the same movement. I'm just gonna feel the same contraction with incline dumbbells, but I can load more weight doing this lift. So I chose to do one more set, and I'm happy. I'm done with it. So, yeah, let's just stick with it. I was happy with the body weight dips. It was kind of funny. I don't know if it was I mean, dips are pretty taxing, but I don't think I was waiting long enough. Every set, I went down by one rep, which is fine. We've not done three sets of body weight yet, so I think in the past we've only done one set. So I'm happy. We'll just stick with the body weight. I think for progression's sake, we might just maybe start with like a – do like a 4x6 on dips or something. And then, you know, because I could have – granted, that was my third exercise, so I was pretty taxed. But just so I can get some more volume out and I don't go to failure, it's just a personal preference. I'm not saying going to failure was wrong. I'm still stimulating my muscle fibers, but I wouldn't mind getting, you know, building my strength up on dips. But, you know, I'm tooting my own horn, bro. That's 230 pounds, you know, and I did how many in three sets? How many reps? I did 15, 21 reps in three sets with body weight 230. So you boy is pretty strong, okay? But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed the full day eating. That editing, man, like the hard cuts, it's fun, but it takes so much longer than my normal videos. I'll just get better at it, you know, because the other ones I just kind of copy and paste the audio and then the graphics, because it's all, I'm trying to be consistent with the timing. So it's usually about a minute, 36 seconds into the intro before the first lift starts. But yeah, it was fun. As you guys can tell, I'm, you know, which my budget allows it, but man, I'm busy with the family and then work and stuff. Like, you know, maybe you could chalk it up as being lazy. I just don't have a lot of time to meal prep, especially with like the YouTube now. I feel like, you know, my social life is definitely taking a back seat, because as soon as the kids go to bed, I'm like staying up and editing videos, you know, until bedtime. But well, that's not true, but you know what I'm saying, it just takes a lot of my afternoons out, which I'm not complaining. I'm just saying what I'm getting at, it's hard for me to make time to do all these things. And yeah, it's probably a little lazy, but you know, I'm in a situation where I can afford the convenient food to make sure my macro goals are hit. So, as you guys can tell, I eat a lot of rice. I like my milk. But yeah, I'm curious to hear what you guys think about the the oatmeal. It looks gross, man. But man, if I don't put milk in my oatmeal, and I just like the peanut butter taste in it, but if I don't put milk in my oatmeal, it's like almost like gags me, dude. You know what I'm saying? I know it looks like a sloppy mess, but I enjoy it. It's not bad. I mean, it's not great, but it's not bad. You know, I don't know. Maybe try it. You know, looks can be deceiving at times, you know? Yeah, I'm gonna go home, eat some chicken, eat some rice, get a shake in, gonna rest up. I got a long day of work ahead of me. And then, yeah, hopefully get some sleep. So I went for like a whole month not talking about my kids, but man, I got one that just did not sleep good last night, and I got like 4.5 hours of sleep, so I'm tired. I'm hoping I can, you know, get the editing done and get some sleep. You know, it's my sleep has suffered a lot since I started making these videos, and it's definitely a priority, but so is making these videos. It's a trade-off, you know. Maybe I complain. Do I complain too much? No. I'm just trying to be real with you guys. Just kind of talking through what's in my head. Maybe I'll never script these. I told you, man, my mom always made the joke that I could have a conversation with a quarter, you know? Just, I don't know. There's a lot of different stuff going on in my head at one time. So I have enough to talk about. But I guess the flip side, the pros to a script is if this would be more organized discussions. So me just rambling about just whatever just pops in my head, you know? Squirrel. But yeah, I'm gonna go home, hydrate some more. Maybe I can take a nap later. I don't know, we'll see. If not, I'm gonna do what I can. The hardest part about editing is not really the editing itself. Except the, you know, the full day eating stuff. Sorry, I had a notification. It's the export. So, I mean, you guys tell me. I'm not a video guy. I'm kind of learning as this goes. But, you know, I record in 4K 30 frames, you know, 30 FPS with my phone. So I was told to export, which makes sense. You don't want to compress your videos because they kind of get wonky. But that's what I export at, is 40 frames, or 30 frames at 4K, at 2060p. And the export on with my editing software, Premiere Pro, it can take like an hour. And I don't know if it's, you know, the perfectionist in me or what, but I have a hard time falling asleep while it's exporting because I don't want it to fail and then get up and scramble, you know, before I go to the gym early in the morning and try to export it again and then make sure I upload it to YouTube. So exporting takes like an hour. But it's not failed in a while. It failed like the first day, but I also didn't know what I was doing. So I think now I'm just gonna trust it, and I'm just gonna hit export on my editing software and then wake up and then upload it to YouTube before I go to the gym. So I don't know, that'll help me get some sleep. But yeah, it was a great day. I'd give it a solid A. Definitely got a chest pump. I'm loving the flies before the incline barbell to kind of, you know, even get warmed up and get my chest activated. We did more weight this week on that. The volume on the incline barbell went down, but I felt stronger. The last two sets, I felt stronger. We'll put more weight on. And then the dips, I definitely felt stronger. And then the iso press, man, it was a solid day, dude. I am fully contracted. My chest is getting filled up, man. I'm liking the progress already on my upper delts. I'm starting to see some thickness. I'm not saying I got a gorilla silverback, you know. I got that silverback action, but it's getting there, man. It's getting there. This weekend for the Sunday video, I'm going to compile my poses from my first chest day, or all these days, compose a before and after, so you guys can kind of see my results, and that, you know, a better way to track it as well. So that'd be a fun episode. And you know, I was thinking, you know, cycling, you know, doing the 4 weeks of the hard compounds, the eccentric 5x8s, and then doing a deload week, whether we're lowering the weight down for more reps or just cutting the sets in half. What's going to be fun about that is the one rep max week, the sixth week. So that'll be fun. You know, every day we'll hit some PRs, and me and Cody will have fun with it. Maybe we'll play some games like horse or something. You know, we'll each pick a lift, and then we'll see who's the strongest. Whoever's the strongest, the other person gets a letter or something like that. You know what I mean? And then that'd be great too, because when we can, you know, I've been saying this a lot for like the past 3 or 4 days. Then we can reevaluate our progressions and then hit it hard for 4 weeks, take a deload, one rep max again. Not that I'm trying to cheat this as powerlifting. We're still bodybuilding, but I want to get my strength up, man. You know, I've said this a lot, and you know, I've copied other people saying this, but you know, mass moves mass, and I want a lot of mass. You know, especially if I'm going to compete one day. I mean, a little gear would help for sure. One day. Well, I mean, shoot, I'm 33, so statistically, you know, when I get 35, my T levels might start to drop. But you know, being in the gym and being active is gonna make sure that they stay up too. I know that. We all know that. But anyway, enough rambling. Much love. You know, hey, being a dead horse like I always do in these videos, make sure you're hydrating. Get a scale, dude. I'm not telling you to go take it to a restaurant. That's maybe psychotic a little bit, you know, especially you out with a pretty girl or a pretty male, whatever your jive is. You probably don't want to bust out a scale. You know, I don't know how impressive that'd be. But make sure you guys are tracking your food, man. I mean, unless you guys got insane instincts and, you know, you guys can evaluate what you're eating by eyeballing it. I mean, more power to you, but I'm not that smart. So weigh your food. Make sure you're drinking at least a gallon of water a day with some electrolytes. Take your supplements for those micronutrients. And just sleep, man. Just sleep as much as you can. I know you guys ain't sleeping either. If you're my age and you got work and stuff, I know it's hard to juggle all this crap, but just make sure you're doing it, you know? Anyway. I love you guys. Thank you so much, man. 220 subs. It's nuts. It's freaking nuts, man. I don't know. I'm starting to feel like this thing might actually go somewhere. But we'll see. I'm going to have fun. What makes it even better, it's like I don't worry about that because I'm having fun. You know, I could stay at the same volume forever and I wouldn't lose any sleep. I would be ecstatic. Just, I appreciate you guys so much, man. I'm never going to stop thanking y'all. I genuinely mean that. You know, everyone's busy and you guys take the time of your day to like be a part of this journey, and that means a lot, man. I've learned a lot since I started doing this too, so thank you. But anyway, I'm gonna go home, rest up, eat some food, and I'll hit some back and triceps tomorrow. All right, peace.